All right, now it's time for Say It With Me. Nailed it! It's all about offering you home improvement tips, and we have Jason McCullough with Brothers Redevelopment, and he's sharing tips on how to properly use a hammer, which I love this. But first, before we get to all the tools here, talk about your big and your annual event that you have coming up.
Sure. Well, it's that time of year again. It's the 41st annual Paint-a-thon. We'll be starting here in the next month or so. So our goal is to paint 100 senior homes in the Denver and surrounding areas. We're happy to say we're extending this to Colorado Springs this year.
Oh, fun.
Yeah, so we're real excited. If you know or are somebody that's over 60, own your home on a lower fixed income, and could use a little help around the house, give us a call. We can get a group out to paint that house and clean that yard.
All right. Your phones are going to be ringing off the hook.
Let's
I love
hope,
this.
Right? Yeah.
All right. Let's talk about the demo you've got for us. Where do we want to start?
Sure. Well, I just...
Steel hammers?
We're going to do hammers.
Okay.
Right tool for the right job.
I love it.
Most people have something like this around their house. This is called a house or a trim hammer.
Okay.
Notice it has a flush flat front. It's nice and shiny, so it doesn't leave marks on the walls as much. It's really light, very versatile.
I think I've used that one before.
Yep, most people have this. This is one you'll see most tradesmen will have.
Okay.
We call this a demo wrecking hammer. Notice it's all steel.
Ooh,
so you can use it.
This is much heavier.
You can use it to construct.
And it's all
this one's
up.
Probably 15 years old. But they last forever. And
that's
awesome. You can use them to hack through. If you're going to throw something through a wall, throw this one.
Throw that one.
Yeah,
okay.
It's a good one to throw through
the
wall.
I like that. Right? Okay.
And we have the classic framer hammer. So notice it's actually lighter, but it's got a really long handle.
Mm-hmm.
Notice the waffle front and the wider head.
Oh.
So that helps people who are framing to grab the nail. It grabs the nail better.
Oh.
So it doesn't skip off, stays on. But anything you touch with that's gonna leave a mark. So you only wanna use this for like rough framing or anything that you're gonna cover afterwards.
Yeah, for sure, because
right?
you don't want anyone seeing
this
that
stuff.
This
is a great hammer, you get so much torque.
I've actually used this before, probably not for the right reasons, but that's, go ahead, I'll let you do the demos.
This is used in a lot of different trades. Around the house, most people use this to adjust doors or cabinets that are sticking.
Right.
Or just anything you wanna tap and move a little bit, but you don't want to leave a mark, and you don't want to hit it too hard.
Right.
This is a great one for that. Plumbers use these a ton, too.
Oh, yeah.
And then you've got, of course, I brought a small version. This is a mini sledge.
Right.
But your sledgehammers are for a lot of you. This one, you notice the dirt, because it's probably been used to beat a root out or something like that. Anything you got to pound out of the ground or pound into the ground, this is a great one.
That is a good one. And I don't know even know if I've seen a smaller one. I've always just seen those ginormous ones.
Yeah, these are good for a lot of stuff we do with renovations, old plumbing, knocking stuff out.
Yeah.
Yep.
All right, what other things do we have on here?
Well, I just figured I'd bring a few tools that you want around the house for general use. If you're going to have a little toolbox, try to have a good pair of pliers. I like these channel locks because they vary in size. You can get a lot of torque on them, and they're good for sticky bolts or nuts, right?
Yeah.
And then, of course, your crescent wrench for anything that's finished that you want to have a specific size to. So you don't want to scratch up or rip it up or have it look all scuffed up afterwards. That's a good one to turn it on. So this is like hooking up your water line to your fridge. If you have an issue with a tub valve, something like that, this is your right here.
A little bit smaller.
And then this goes with any time you have a hammer, you're probably going to need one of these. This is a base shoe lifter. So it can be used as a pry bar to pull nails.
Oh.
It can be used to pry things up. It can be used to pound things in. It's just a great tool to have in your tool belt for all-around use.
I love that. That's
a
perfect idea. I don't even think I ever knew what that was for.
Right,
but
mostly
now
for
I know.
Lifting. If you're going to do your flooring, we use it to lift up the trim.
Okay.
And then you can slide the new flooring under and then...
I love this.
Yep.
All right, well, let's talk about this paint-a-thon again.
Sure.
Now, how do you help with this? And anyone who needs your services can give you a call, right?
Absolutely.
But under of a certain age and that of need? Or?
So for the paint-a-thon services, which is our volunteer department, you need to be 60 or older or have a verifiable disability.
Okay.
And that just means it's pretty obvious.
Yeah.
For our house services, our home assistance services, that's anybody that owns their home and is on a lower fixed income. In the areas we serve, which are from Adams County all the way to El Paso, we can do things like wheelchair ramps, tub-to-shower changeouts, damage repair, deferred maintenance with your furnace and your water heater.
Yeah.
I can come and help you with that. So if you're giving up something in your house for medicine or food because you're on a fixed income, call us. Chances are we can help or we can get somebody to help you.
This is so important. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Learn more, and you need to do this online. Go ahead. About all the outreach programs at brothersredevelopment.org. Here's the number, folks, 844-926-6632. That is awesome. Thank you, Jason.